I'm riding like a grandma at the moment, but it's really, really slippery here.
So this morning we woke up with sheep around our tent. Like we expected, we saw some footprint yesterday. It was really cute, so we heard them walking around and eating.
We're like 20 of them, right?
No, even more. It was like a real big group.
Yeah. We were quite loud.
Well, it was cute. Yeah.
So yesterday we came back after our walk. As you can see, my front tire is slipping away. Yeah, okay, that's better. So yesterday we were we came back from our walk, and the other campers were still struggling with the fire, and after an hour they still couldn't get it on. So we helped out a bit. And,
yeah, we got bait with marshmallows and wine. So but we had a fun evening with the other three Dutch girls.
Yeah, it was cool sharing some stories about where they came from in the Netherlands and what they were doing in Sweden. So
today we're gonna go to Torekov. There is another shelter nearby the coast this time, so looking forward to that. We need to check out if we can get by the shelter, because there was no road there.
Oh, this looks quite wet again. I think it rained a lot. Hey, are these the same sheep? So we made a bit of a mistake yesterday. Before we planned our trip, we had the idea to buy souvenirs for family and stuff from Sweden. We thought, well, we don't have the room on the motorcycle, so maybe we can send it back.
Yeah.
Biggest mistake ever, because we didn't check the price at that moment. So yesterday we went to a shopping center and we bought about 50 euros worth of food and stuff to send back. And then we went to the oh man, what's this?
Oh yeah. Camping
on the farmer's land. I don't really get that. Maybe it's cool, but if you have all the nature to camp wild in, why would you stand on a green field next to a house? It's kind of a waste. But okay, so we we didn't check the price beforehand. Turns out it costs about 70 euros to just send the package. Which we didn't expect and didn't check, which is totally stupid. And so we ended up getting a better price at another postal station on the other side of town.
Yeah, but the package, yeah, we couldn't put it on the back of the bike, so I had to hold it between
yep.
us with both my hands. And normally I hold on to Luke while we ride, but even apart from the highway, I was carrying the package. It was quite heavy. It was like 10, 15 kilograms, but worked out.
Yeah, we sent it for about 40 euros, I think. So it was still really expensive, but we couldn't return the goods.
Nah.
We drove about 1.5 hours and we found our shelter, so I think we're going to go out to get some stuff to throw on the grill later this evening.
Maybe some lux.
Maybe some lux if we can find it.
Tot zo.
Tot zo.
Moi.
Moi.
Let's go for a swim.
Swim.
okay. Let's go dip our feet in.
Stand in the waves.
Stand in the waves.
The Ika didn't have fresh fish, so we bought hamburgers and potatoes to throw in the fire.
Yeah.
With some aluminum foil.
Okay, let's go back.
Okay. Aww. Oh, that was that.
Again, the sound of the wind and the sea was really soothing.
Yeah.
I'm riding on a bit of an illegal road, I think. It's not really meant for a motorcycle, but we went there anyway because we wanted to have it close to the camp.
Yeah. Oh, I find it really cool to see all those trees.
Yeah, they're blown over by the wind, so
yeah,
they're completely diagonal. So they're growing like that now.
Yeah.
Really cool.
Last night some other people joined us at the shelter. A Danish man with his bicycle came along and
Don't envy him.
Hmm?
I don't envy him.
No. And two Swedish girls also came here. They parked their car somewhere farther away. They told us about their journey, that they went for 2 weeks right now, and they went from the most northern point to the most southern point of Sweden, east to west, the highest point, the lowest point in Sweden. It was really cool to hear. Oh yeah.
I'm waiting a bit here.
They were quite tired after the long drive.
Yeah, I don't really like setting goals as much, especially those kind of goals that are really far to ride. Because, as you said, they were really tired, and they told us a story about the most high point where they went in Sweden, and they focused totally on that goal, went there, slept in the car, and whatever, and. They went to the highest point and it was misty, so they couldn't see anything. So that's really disappointing, I think. And I kind of we have smaller goals, and then we just enjoy the ride. And I think you miss a lot if you set such ambitious goals, which make you just stressed to get there and focus on the goal itself,
yeah,
and just don't enjoy the ride to where you're going. Because there's so much to see here.
Yeah. Right now we're on the way to Skåne, the province. A long time ago I lived there for a year. And right now we're going in the area to find another shelter and show Luca around, because he has never been there.
Yeah, I'm very curious to see where you live. So we're going to ride that way, and we'll see you there. Tot zo.
Tot ziens.